We have an update now on the volcano eruption in Guatemala. The death toll is up to at least 25 people, and nearly 2 million are being affected in some way.
The Fuego volcano sent black smoke and ash into the sky on Sunday, which drifted all the way to the capital, Guatemala City, some 40 kilometers away. Officials say evacuations and rescues are underway. More than 3,000 people have been forced from their homes. All right.
Let's get more on it from our meteorologist, Ivan Cabrera. You know, Ivan, we've been talking about Hawaii for so long, and now Guatemala, and one eruption and 25 people have already lost their lives.
Completely different event. Guys, right, no question about it here. And the scenes coming out of Guatemala, they're certainly not what we've had in Kilauea. People just covered in soot. You see all the folks running out of the way. 25 killed, a lot of people. And this happened because of the proximity of a particular town called El Rodeo that's right on the foot of the volcano that just didn't have enough time to get out of the way. 4:55, violent eruption. This is the second of this year, but it is the most violent that they've had in this particular volcano in 40 years, as you can imagine here. Ash cloud, well, that went up to the sky as high as 10 kilometers. And they're describing it as a river of lava that came down the mountainside and moved directly through the village, which is why we had so many fatalities. And of course, as you can imagine, the injuries will be a lot of burn injuries ongoing here. And we hope those folks are gonna make it. By the way, the ash and soot, as far as 40 kilometers inland, capital city, further away. I saw a little bit of it, but certainly nothing like they've seen close to where the event occurred here. So there's the Fuego volcano. We have many around, but that's the one that has caused this calamity in just the last 12 hours here. In fact, I was here this morning, nothing doing. All of a sudden, the world can change so quickly for a lot of people. There's the town that we're talking about there. You see how close it is and why we've had so many issues. Now, over the next few days, we're going to watch the weather very closely here because any kind of rainfall or anything like that, and we do have some in the forecast, could produce some additional issues with all the lava that's come out of the volcano. So at this point here, I don't think they're quite done, right? We talk about search and rescue. They're still trying to see how many people may be needing some help as a result of this volcano. We'll keep you posted over the next several hours. A lot of information still to come. Guys.
All right, Ivan, thanks so much.